All right. I am gonna exit the game. I'm gonna play the what do you call it? The New Order. So I'm gonna play as Albert Speer. Romania, you get something similar, just makes Bulgaria and Romania like one another more. Oh. Okay, so it's not, they don't actually join, they don't actually become a part of the Yugoslavian realm, I guess. All right. I will be right back. All right, I'm back. Let's do this. Playing as Albert Speer's Germany, a moderate reformist Germany. You get used to it after a while. But yeah, I didn't like it at first. We're going to play the big man himself, Adolf Hitler. The Gross Germanisches Reich. Oh shit. Huh. I didn't even realize there was something like this. Cool. All right. Man on the Moon. Cool. Nova Polska, yeah. So this is the Polish state. Yeah. I know. I'm not quite sure, but I think Nova Polska can actually create a Russian empire. It's weird. Well, because, and the reason why I say that is because it's in the Russian area, and like most states, if not all states, are capable of actually like conquering Russia. You know what? Let's test that out. Oh shit, we can. No, it's just it was overlapping. It's Vatican City and Rome. Oh yeah, big Romania, of course. It had to happen. So, yeah, Hungary fell apart because you know how in World War II, Hungary got like this bit as part of like Greater Hungary from the Treaty of Belgrade or whatever you call it. So Hungary fell apart after the Second World War, and Romania took advantage and took all of this stuff back. As the one second Vienna Award. So yes, you can actually solidify control over Kazakhstan as Nova Polska. And I think after they take Kazakhstan, they can actually go for Russia. So I'm just gonna quit and get back to the Gross Germanisches Reich. Yeah, that too. Shit, yeah, we've got to do this again. And we're going to go improve our APCs. APCs are very good. I love APCs. More APC. More guns. More everything. It really doesn't matter because we're going to go have a civil war in a sec. Hans Spiegel. Bam. Bam. Oops, nope. Bam. Bam. Just gonna have a look at our generals here. Sure, Franz Beilein. Blah 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 blah. Yeah, take that too. Cool. Let's go, Mr. Hitler. All right, give me a sec. Okay, cool. The Brown Eminence. All right. Oh yeah. Very colorful, some of these. Yeah, I like the Burgund's flag. It's just black. Mostly black. Oh, yeah, of course. Yeah, why not? I think technically, all of Serbia is supposed to be, it's also supposed to be demilitarized. All right. Reich's last conquest. The final frontier for Nazism. You might not have been watching the stream, but I was playing as Heinrich Himmler the other day, and I actually, so bit of backstory. So, Heydrich, I'm oh, not really backstory. Heydrich is never supposed to win the Civil War unless there is player intervention. Like, Heydrich only has like five provinces here, and that's it. Oh, and bits in the east as well, but that gets swallowed up by Göring. Like, it is impossible for him to win without like outside intervention. So when I got Heydrich to win with Heinrich Himmler's support, he nuked the entire world with the German arsenal of weapons. Like, it was literally game over when Heydrich won the German Civil War. So Himmler, after a certain point in time, I'm not sure when, I think it probably was the West Russian War when he tried to take over the German Reich. Himmler kind of went insane. Well, not really insane. Well, he had a very twisted way of looking at things. After a while, he effectively thought that the Aryan race would essentially would survive a nuclear apocalypse, and he essentially wanted to wipe everyone out as a test for the Aryans, for the Germanic peoples. So normally Heydrich loses the German war, and Himmler tries to start a nuclear apocalypse on his own. But when Heydrich wins, because Heydrich is essentially Himmler's lapdog, when Heydrich wins, he just uses the German stockpile of nukes and nukes everything. Starts a nuclear war with America, who has the nuclear stockpile of their own. Tries nuking the Japanese, who also have nukes as well. Bam, blows everything up. Everyone dies. Well, not everyone, because stuff happens after the end, but yeah. It's Heinrich Himmler. He's like, yeah, he's the worst. There's a reason why this mod is called The Last Days of Europe. Like, it's essentially just named after, it's because of Heinrich Himmler's like fucking crazy fanatical nuclear wanderlust. Right. In this universe, did something get nuked? Yes. Pearl Harbor. Pearl Harbor got nuked. So, United States didn't join the war because Roosevelt didn't get elected. He didn't get elected, so the United States was isolationist and never actually like built up their army or their navy. I mean, if, I'm not sure if you know about your history, your pre-World War II history, but essentially Roosevelt was the reason why America was prepared for a war. Like, if it wasn't for Roosevelt, like, the United States would have been just like just another nation in the Americas. It would have been a better target, but it would have been too far away for the Japanese to nuke. So they went with Pearl Harbor. And Germany didn't declare war on the United States, so they would never have had an opportunity to nuke New York or just anywhere in the Eastern Coast. Yeah, the Japanese did it. Oh yeah, Japan has most of China under their control. Oh, and Mianjiang as well. That's funny. The communists are in Mongolia are still a thing. All right. Back to Germany. Back to this. Wow, I didn't. Wow, there weren't a lot of debt here. This is really bad. Let's go with Albert Speer. Increase his influence. Assassin strikes at Hitler. Adler is launched. Hitler's gonna die soon. Yeah, we're going to go with the reformer. Cool. Burgundian system. Yeah. No, essentially, it's 1984. Yeah. So, Burgundy. So, the reason why Burgundy exists as a nation is because Hitler, because Himmler tried to. He tried a coup, Germany during the West Russian War, and this was found out. Hitler essentially relocated Himmler and the SS to the West, here in Burgundy, thinking, "Oh yes, this is going to pacify the SS, and you know they're going to have to essentially like." The SS is going to have to deal with a population, you know, who's expecting the partisans to take up most of their time and attention. But Himmler found ways to essentially pacify the population. And now Himmler, you know, most of his focus is essentially just trying to undermine the German Civil War. A lot of the German factions in the Civil War, and fucking with everyone on the map. they've got a decision tree called Global Plan, which is essentially like okay, so they can go and try and break up the Iberian Union or intervene in the war in Palestine in the Levant. Stuff like that. They're kind of like the communists in base game Hearts of Iron, where they're like trying to create revolts and revolutions around the world. But he's doing it more just to make things worse for everyone, rather than for any ideological reasons. Student revolt. Wow. Cool. Awesome. Oh, man. Cool. All right, see ya. Huh. Cool. Let's calm down the whatever you call them, Wehrmacht. Huh. Fuck. Okay. More troops. Give me more troops. Oh, shit. It's happening now. Hitler's gonna die. Yep. Pretty awful. I agree. Know, half the revolts around the world in like German occupied territories are actually like Jewish revolts. Essentially just like partisans who'd been hiding this entire time, noticing the civil war and going, "Oh shit, yeah, this is the time to strike." Yeah, they probably have. Well, they did during World War II, though. Yeah. I guess, yeah. Probably not. The only reason, I think one of the reasons why they were hiding it was because of because they didn't want to provoke or antagonize the British and the French. So yeah. Mean they hit it like up leading up to the Olympics, they essentially hit it. Because of exactly that, they just didn't want everyone else to know, so that they didn't start like sympathizing with the partisans. Or not, well, not sympathizing with the partisans. There were no partisans sympathizing with the oppressed. Alright, Hitler's about to die. Yay. The Suda crisis. Madagascar is falling apart. Here's an example of a Jewish revolt in Madagascar. Of course, they moved. They actually shipped Jewish, some of the Jews to Madagascar. Out. Fuck. A sensible economy. Oh, thanks for the follow, John Baker 909888. Yeah, it's crazy. I've been getting a lot of people following the last couple of days. Been constant after a drought of like no followers. All right, look for more opportunities. All right. Scale back military production. Opening the market there. Open that shit up. Okay. What year is it now? 63. Bam. There we go. Cool. Too little, too late. Oh, what the fuck? Salazar is the ruler, the leader of Spain. What happened there? Hey. All right. Okay. Let the war begin soon. Oh, he's dead. All right, the civil war's about to start. Okay. Higher than the Reich. Fuck. Let's go. Let's go with the Wunsch camp. I'm much deeper. You guys join this main battle plan here. Bam. We're gonna put everyone on the front here like this. Actually, I just realized. Yeah, okay, we want some people up here. So we're gonna have. You guys up in the north and the rest down in the south. Let's just do guns for now. I get the feeling Goering is going to be the easiest to take out, so I'm going to go push in like this and take Hamburg and that pocket and just like take out, wipe out these troops. So let's go. Odenstadt-Burgund declares war on France. Okay, slide that down. On, what the fuck? Fuck, come on, dude. Fuck that shit. Come on, dude. Coup in Crimea. Cool. Awesome. Crimea River. Kidding me? Come on. Okay. Come on, you guys. Let's go. You fucks. Awesome. Awesome. More students to this line. Sure. Yes. Fuck yes. Just move into there. Go. Cool. Cool. Meh. We don't need to do any of that. I can win this war very quickly soon. Fuck, serious? Oh, okay, whatever. Just stop moving. Fuck. What the fuck? The Bretons failed to secure a black market order. Market. Oh my god. Fuck. Right. I think what we're gonna do is push. We're gonna push on this front here. Or wait for these guys to starve, but I think we're probably better off pushing. So you guys, push to Munchen. And then we'll, I don't know. Yeah, just keep pushing. We'll go for Munchen and then Vien. Fuck yes. Fuck. Fuck. Ah, oh, they took the tanks out. Fuck. Let's just fucking wipe them out. Fuck them up. Fuck yes. And now we're just up this guy to go. Death to Hydric. Cool. Cool. All right. Germany is finally reunited. Alrighty. Doppeldenken. Doppeldenken. All right, cool. More of this. That's nice. All right, cool. All right. Dear Craig M. Surin, we're going to stop this war. Win the war. Cool. Oh, right, this. Okay, I thought I don't know why it said decisions, but I kept thinking, oh, it must be must have something to do with focuses. I don't know why. Let's go with Bohemians for now. We're definitely on a conservative focus. Cool. Go. Watch the campaign.
Zum Ausrücken.
Cool. Awesome. Cool. Awesome. Finally. Oops. I'll do that again. Fuck. I just realized that interrupt the focus. So I'm going to go back in a second though. The Bohemians refuse. Are you kidding me? Just like that. Okay. That was insane. Fucking refuse. Let's go with Polish Thorn. Yeah, nope. We're doing in the aggressive option. Yeah, there's a Mediterranean dam. Yeah. Not sure if there was a reference or something that I missed. Yeah. No. Well, the English were probably going to do it anyways, even if they'd even if the government had actually stayed in power. Claude. What's his name? Auchinleck. Oh, great Hungarian game, eh? No, Montgomery actually, he's in charge of the Kingdom of England, the collaborator government's armies. He's actually one of the traitors. All right, war in Poland. Let's go. Let's go for the invasion of Poland. Oh man, the SS is actually winning in the east. I'm gonna have to do something about this. Fuck. Gonna take what's rightfully ours. We'll do that in a sec. I have no idea. All right. Cool. Luring it to another Blitzkrieg. Let's go. War in Germany. War in Africa. War in German Africa. It'd be funny if I just like let them take Germany, and yeah, oh man. All right, cool. Yeah. All right. Oh, fuck. Yeah, I'm not. I don't know. I don't know. All right. I think I understand how this works now. Okay, cool. Yeah, we're not going to anger the corporations. Nope. Oh, interesting. Oh shit, the focus tree's gone. Oh. That's good. It's a funny one. Right, we're gonna go back. Damn it, we're gonna have to go with the minimum wage. Oh, there it is. Cool. Hello, how's it going? You can see by the title, I'm playing as Albert Speer in the German Reich, the Greater German Reich. 20 years or so after the end of the Second World War. Yeah, no, I'm good. Okay, cool, we won. Alrighty, let's smuggle the radical guns into the country. Yeah, probably che. Where's your just realized Tiddy Bug is on. Cool. Armed forces. Cool. We still got a war with South Africa. Holy shit. Right, we're gonna send some volunteers in. This is just taking too long. Oh, we can just send another one. Oh, we can send one each, so one here. One there, cool. Let's have a look at this first. Fuck, the magnet's a 10. Fuck. No, we're not offering a ceasefire. We're gonna end this war for good, for reals. Right. State of the Reich, the heart of Russia. If I can find it, there we go. Awesome. Peace in the East. Halberstadt. Where is that? Alright. Reaffirm their loyalty. Arrival in a German circle estate. Yes. Okay, back to the pact. Huh. Yes. Ah, oh, cool. Awesome. We made it to 10. Okay. Out through the Krim, through the Crimean, I think that's what it means. Yeah. Oh shit, Carl Dönitz is still here as well. Wonder if he's coming back. Cool. Fuck yes. Alright, let's take that shit. Noah Polska is actually doing well in Kazakhstan. Holy shit. Lebensraum is ours once again. Mussolini died. This is the son in law of Benito Mussolini, Galeazzo Cucinò. All right. I should point out Galeazzo Ciano is actually a Democrat. So you're going to see that Italy becomes a democracy in the next couple of years. In fact, like right about now, actually. Let's go with this. Suspend the persecution. All right, a new game. Four. Sonderbericht. All right, cool. Alrighty, awesome. Yes. All right. Sure. Walk. Yeah, probably. It's not really Mussolini, it's Galeazzo Ciano is the next best thing. Oh, Kaiserreich. Sure. Black spot. Possibly, yeah. Probably. Oh shit. Oh, yeah. I know about it. I've seen Mussolini and Kaiserreich many times. I generally like. Like if I play Italy, I like playing as the legionary because they have a war goal on Austria. really early war goal as well, so it can be fairly useful if like the Belgrade Pact declares war on them. You just have a casus belli in handy. Okay, we're going with the United States. It is stronger. I agree. Like at the start, Mussolini's Italy has an alliance first. Oh, it didn't have an alliance, but it's adjacent to its closest ally, potential ally with Italy. If you were to go like fascist Italy in Republican Italy, you essentially have no allies. You're effectively surrounded by Austrians who want to kill you, and the socialists who are the exact opposite in terms of ideology. So you're kind of fucked. But that's kind of why I like playing as the fascists in Italy, because they just got no chance. Yeah. Same with Kingdom of Two Sicilies. They're in a similar position, but they've got better infrastructure and they've got way more land as well. So, not as interesting, but yeah. Anyways, seems the wives have got more privileges. I'm not sure. I don't think I'm going to add any rules. You know what? With Italy, they're a bit weird. I don't think they actually have the ability to conquer France because they're socialists. So you're never really going to be able to reform the Roman Empire. France or Spain. They can go for Illyria, so they can go for Austria, but that's about it. And Sardinia, which is Entente province. I guess. Imagine that's fairly tough, though. Here's the thing, though. It's hard for France to lose against Germany because usually when, at least nowadays, when Germany gets declared on by France, usually Russia's not very far behind because of how the focus tree is designed. Usually they try and take advantage of the Weltkrieg and invade from the east. So, yeah. Cool. Let's load back. Back. Was Russia involved in a war against Germany? Was usually Germany fighting on two fronts. I mean, historically, that's never never worked very well in the past, and it never works well in Kaiserreich, so their muscles are a bit of at war. Maybe Russia had the Soviets. Maybe the Soviets had their civil war. Yeah. Right. Back. What am I doing? Where are we? We are not alone. We've got some alliances. Take back France. I've already got France. Ordenstadt Burgundy is our like state in France. Any enemy of my enemy. Cool. Fuck. It's a tie. Cool. Cool. Better education is always good. All right, sure. Oh, we got communists. Alrighty, we're gonna shut down these companies. Hey. Oh wow, that's a lot of options. Fuck. Oh, we've got the internet here. That's right. Oh wow, I like that focus. Fuck. That looks so nice. Holy shit. Okay. All right. Everything. Sent everything and everyone. Cool. Cool. Right, have a look at that stuff later. Okay. He hasn't returned to the fold. He's still technically in charge. Oh fuck, I just drew off the time. I think I'm gonna stop playing. Oh man, it's fire. All right. So that was a good game. Good game. Interesting playthrough as Albert Speer. I will continue the playthrough for quite some time, up until the mod essentially kicks me out and says, "Oh, there's no more content." I imagine there's more content for about maybe 5 to 10 years, and then it's pretty much done. I think. Yeah, so as of course, one of the suggestions for a campaign after this was Mussolini's Totalist Italy for Kaiserreich. I'm considering something like that. Maybe even also, maybe not Kaiserreich, I think. I think I really like, I actually much prefer the New Order. I really like the mechanics in this mod. So I'm probably going to play as the Italian Empire and the New Order. Or maybe alternate between the two. I'm really looking forward to some of the new mechanics that they new mechanics, new focus trees, or even extending the focus trees for the next like 10, 15 years or whatever for these factions. I'm actually curious to see how they do it because, like with games with mods like Kaiserreich, right? They only really plan for the focus trees to last for about 5 to 10 years, you know? Like it's all very focused around the second Veldkrieg and nothing else. Like everything past the Veldkrieg is completely irrelevant in the end of this. Like if you're watching my United Kingdom playthrough, once you become the United Kingdom, sorry, not United Kingdom playthrough, Canada, whatever. But once you become the United Kingdom after you take it from the communists, there really isn't much to do. You can okay, so you can take back the empire, pre-Veldkrieg empire, but that's it. And I don't know, that just kind of disappointed me. Like I expected more in the updated focus tree. I mean, it's still better than what it was before. But yeah, just it didn't click. Didn't click with me. Oh, I didn't even realize Africa fell apart. Holy shit. Oh, here's another thing, right? With the Afrikaner Abwehrfront. I think there should be a focus tree for this. Like, if Africa falls apart, these guys should be able to take it back with this, the assistance of Germany. Yeah. All right. Let's I gotta pack in, pack up, finish the game. So thanks for watching. Follow if you'll be notified of as to when I stream this next. I have no idea when I'm gonna stream this next. I'm probably like 8 hours, 10 hours from now. It really depends on when I wake up, how long it takes me to wake up after I actually get up. I just, yeah. I spend like an hour just pretty much just kind of half awake, half asleep after I wake up. Anyways, outro, let's go.